My wife has this friend who she spends a lot of time with. She eats with her, she does her makeup with her, she sings to her, and she even makes sure she's taken care of on a regular basis. That friend is Rhonda the Honda. Here in America, and of course Polk County, we all love our cars, but there are alternatives, and thankfully, to teach us what the benefits are of those alternatives and how it can save us money and save the environment, we have people like our guest here today, Christina Diaz-Pagan, the Program Director for FDOT District 1 Commuter Services. How are you doing today, Christine?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me here today.
Yeah, absolutely. I guess that's the best place to start is, what is Commuter Services, and how would someone like me, who drives to and from work by myself every day, benefit from using them?
Well, definitely. I'm glad you asked. Well, Commuter Services is a state-funded program. We handle 12 counties, and it goes from Polk to Collier County. Within that district, District 1 of FDOT, I work with different employers, and employers have employees. They have a lot of employees that are going to and from work, fighting that day commute every day. Mm-hmm. Well, the nice thing about the program is that I go in and I help you register with Commuter Services, and we start commuter programs for you. Biking, maybe some people can bike to work, carpooling, walking to work. We have people that can telework to work, transit. So you can use all the alternative modes on a day-to-day and register with our program, and then find all the resources to tap you into those programs.
And you just talk about making these partnerships that allow for employers to then go to their employees and say, here's some options, here's the benefits to you. Just talk a little bit about some of the partnerships that you guys have been growing, especially this past year, as you make a lot of progress at Commuter Services.
Well, the nice thing is that the program has grown immensely, and that means that people are getting to be proactive. They're thinking about their commutes. They're thinking about ways to save money. You know, driving every day to work can be stressful sometimes, and sometimes you need to find the right resource that will help you, either finding a carpool match, mm-hmm. or, you know, a bike buddy, you know, or mm-hmm. walking or anything like that. Companies, Legoland is an employer partner that we've had, and working with them on a day-to-day. We talked earlier about the Universal Access Program, mm-hmm. how this particular employer can give rides to their employees. They can ride for free. We also have strong carpools that have started there. All it takes is a company to open their doors and mm-hmm. say, we're interested, we want to make a change, we want our employees to save money, we want to start some kind of maybe pre-tax program, or maybe they want to start a program that will educate their employees on safety or on the use, or maybe just match them up with someone else so they can get a ride every day.
So what's stopping people from doing this? I mean, is it just that you guys continue to go out there and say, here's examples of it working, and here's the true benefit of it, not just to the employer, but to the county, to everyone involved? It seems like you kind of said before, it's a win-win situation. How are you taking this next step then, I guess, in using these examples to kind of, you know, create a countywide partnership?
Well, what we do is we work with the different organizations, and the county is a big, you know, sponsor of the program. What we do is we go to health fairs, we go maybe to an employee orientation, you know, register the new employees, get them educated. Once they're educated, once they're registered, we can email them. We do challenges. We were talking about a lot of challenges that mm-hmm. we do. Try it days. You know, a lot of people, they get scared about different commutes, you know, not knowing mm-hmm. what's out there, kind of like the strange, the different, you know.
Have you ridden a bus?
Yes, I have.
Okay. And you're still here sitting with us today,
right? And I am, and let me tell you, you know, it's nice. You can, I'm a person that uses my iPhone. You know, I take it out all the time. You know, I find myself doing business while I'm on the phone. If you're in a carpool with somebody else, you know, let that driver, you know, obviously don't text and drive, but
That's
let
right.
that person drive, and you can go in the back, and, you know, you can, you know, with all the smartphones that are happening right now, as long as you have some internet, mm-hmm. you can get a lot of work done. You know, it's not just socially, you can get a lot of work done.
Right, and speaking of the internet, obviously you guys have a website where
yes.
people who, not just for employers, but for individuals who want to get registered and be part of the carpooling system. Talk
yes.
a little bit about some of the programming that's available through your website.
Well, somebody can go in, they can, commuterservicesfl.com, they mm-hmm. can just log in. There's a place where they can find out what companies are already partnered with us, who offers the emergency ride home, mm-hmm. what organizations are there. There's also biking information with the trails. It tells you how to find a bike buddy, what events are happening in your area. Teleworking, it talks about the do's and don'ts, what employers have it. You can also find out how to find a carpool match. I mean, somebody probably says, nobody lives next to me. Isn't that the excuse you always hear? There's nobody that lives in my area.
It might
area.
Be good for somebody else, but for me...
Oh, I don't know, and I don't think there's anybody available. Well, the nice thing about it is that you can put your information, you set up your profile. Once you set up your profile, you know, the system will know where you work, where you're traveling to, the times, and they can match you up with another commuter within your organization, or even within the, you know, in your travel area. Maybe somebody across the street is going to the same place that you're going to. There's a toll-free number that a person could call, 866-585-RIDE. Okay. You can call that number. You can get registered over the phone. You could also go in and find out about transit, a lot of information, parking rides that are out there, some safety tips. You know, the holidays are coming up.
Right.
And we like to give information. You know, I think about us as a one-stop program, a program that will educate people and give you different options. The thing is about it is, you know, if you know what's out there, you're more likely to use the different resources.
Right. Well, before the show, I was looking at the website because there's a cost savings calculator.
There is.
And I was thinking, okay, let's plug this in because I live literally a hop, skip, and a jump away from work. It's about a 15-mile commute total each day for me, not much at all. But then you look in at the depreciation of your vehicle, the
wear
oil
and tear.
Changes. It was like $170, $180 a month. And with I have a newborn on the way, my first one, I'm thinking that's like 2 months worth of diapers right there. Maybe.
Definitely.
But I mean, it just shocked me because I'm like, oh, it's probably like $50. And it was almost four times.
No, you kind of, you got to think about all the different wear and tears on the car.
Right.
And just the time.
And the insurance and everything.
The insurance. And there's a lot of people that once they get into a carpool, they go back and they report to their insurance and they say, I'm part of a carpool. I'm leaving my vehicle at home every day. So now I'm using my friend's vehicle to get to work every day.
Right.
Or maybe in a van pool. I mean, how nice to be in a van pool and just have somebody pick you up every day and you're just lying back and just, you know, working on your stuff or just, you know, checking your emails or getting in touch with the family while you're traveling to work. I mean, those are nice. And programs like that, we cover the emergency ride home with a company. So four times a year, if you get stranded, we'll cover your cost to get you home.
Wow, that's, I mean, that's like AAA, except it doesn't cost you the
membership
fee.
Yeah, I tell people,
fee.
this is state funded, so you don't pay anything. You know, we want to reward people for using an alternative mode, and not just that, a safety net. I mean, you know you're covered. You know, if your carpool buddy gets sick, or if you got a sick child, you have to run home, don't worry about it. You're going to be covered, because we're going to help you get a ride.
Right, and that's part of what we were discussing before the show, is that it is about not just creating these programs, but creating programs that define excellence in their field.
Yes.
And you were talking about how they have these awards at a national level for the best workplaces for commuters. Will you kind of share with our audience a little about that?
I would love to share. Let me tell you, this is a great award. It's called Best Workplaces for Commuters, and it's actually offered through the Center for Urban Transportation Research, which is CUTTER for short, because that's a long...
And that's down at USF, right?
Yeah, they're in Tampa. And you know what? This program, in combination with our program, what we do is we go in and we evaluate an employer to see what they're doing. And employers that are doing excellence in commuting benefits and saving their employees money, they can get recognized on a national level.
Wow.
And the nice thing about it is that, I mean, you know, they can be proud of what they're doing, you know, with their employers. And you know what? A lot of employers are using this as a recruitment tactic. They're saying, hey, we have a commuter program. We care about our employees. We set these programs up so employees have solutions for their costs. And they help them save money. Pre-tax transit. There might be a pre-tax program for biking. You know, the carpools. They're saving money. Transit, you know, just management with the park and rides. I mean, there's so many great resources. I tell people just call us, go online, register. It's free. It's a win-win situation for everybody.
Right. And how do you foresee just kind of using some of these early examples of the excellence to try to motivate other people? You're talking a little bit about how the county is a partner who's going to hopefully maybe have an event to kind of showcase some of that. What are some of the
details? I have to tell you that the county has really taken ownership, you know, inviting us to different events. The county wants to bring in, and we're still, you know, working all the details, but they're looking to set a pre-tax program for transit. They have carpool spaces. They have a lot of people registered, you know, with bikers. We have bikers, people that are coming in on their bikes. There are some great trails here. I mean, you have to, you know, there are resources here. We need to just connect everybody to them. And the county, what they're going to be doing is they're going to have an event, and they're going to showcase, they're going to invite all the partners and companies that are having, you know, that have the best workplaces on a national level, and maybe they're a gold or platinum level partner. They're going to showcase them, and the commissioners are going to give them the award and just recognize them. But they want to lead. You know, and you have to, what is it, walk the walk,
yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Pretty much, you know, or bike, and if you're going to bike, make sure you bike the bike.
Exactly.
And so these are great programs, and, you know, I tell companies, hey, if you're interested, give us a call. Mm-hmm. You know, if your employees are interested, if you want a program like this set up, I mean, we would be more than happy to help. And it's about collaboration and resources.
Yeah. I guess finally, what is it that, obviously you're pretty enthusiastic about
it. I love my job.
I mean,
yes.
Some people have jobs and some people have passions. It seems like you fall under the ladder. What keeps you kind of motivated, and what have you learned in the time that you've been with Commuter Services that continues to just encourage you to get the word out?
Well, you know what? There are different ways to get around. There's not, you don't have to just, you know, ride your car every day.
Yeah.
When I hear these success stories, when somebody emails me, mm-hmm. or they, you know, I see them at an event, like earlier today we had an event, and they're telling me, I'm biking to work for the first time ever.
Right.
I've lost 20 pounds.
Well, right,
you know,
right.
I feel healthy. I feel fit. You have more energy. Or somebody that says, you know, I was scared to ride the bus.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was scary. I didn't know what to expect. And I rode it. You did a campaign to try it, a Try Transit Day. I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
Or my organization, we're going to challenge another chamber. You know, our employees are going to ride, you know, the bus more. We're going to walk more. We're going to carpool. I mean, just hearing, or somebody telling me that they saved so much money. You know, it's amazing. Or somebody says, you know what, this is a company that I'm working for, and they have a commute program. They care about the environment. They care about me saving money. I mean, this is, you know, it kind of gives me the warm and fuzzies, and I'm
yeah.
like, you know what, it motivates me on a rough day and on a day that I'm traveling all over the district.
Mm-hmm.
I could say, you know what, you know, commuters, you know, I care about commuters, and you know what, and commuters care about the environment and working mm-hmm. together, and it's a win-win situation.
Right. So, Christine, when an employer or individual comes to you and says, I'm interested in some of the stuff that Commuter Services offers, what kind of resources do you have, and what would you kind of present to them?
So glad you asked. If I go to a company, I come with tools. I mm-hmm. come with a toolkit, and this is part of it. I have a partner toolkit that I have, and it has information about the program. I have posters. I have stuffers for paycheck stuffers. I have all the materials. An employer doesn't have to recreate anything. They can just go in and plug their information. We're here to give them resources and to make it easy for everybody. There's a website. There's a call center. They can just go in and get all the resources. We'll bring our staff to an event. We'll cover the whole event and help them register all the employees. We'll even survey them for free.
Well, as you can tell, Christine is all about what she likes to call lightly transportation transformation.
Yeah.
And the resources are out there, and people like her are helping plug Polk County organizations and individuals into those programs. So as she said, the website is commuterservicesfl.com, where you can get registered to be part of that database for carpooling, emergency rides home, and some of the other programs. And be on the lookout here on PGTV, as well as within the community, for marketing regarding some upcoming events that the Board of County Commissioners will be talking about. And remember, the next time you're sitting at a traffic light, that there could be someone sitting next to you sharing that cost, and people like Christine are there to help. So thank you, Christine, for coming on today.
Thank you for having me. It's always a pleasure.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.